Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about adding and subtracting expressions with different denominators. And this is a whole series on rational expressions. In order to add or subtract with different denominators, you first have to find the least common denominator. Once you have the LCD, you change both fractions to have that LCD, and then you add those together and simplify if possible. And so I put an example up here that you would remember from your past, like 1/3 and 1/4. A lot of times we wrote that vertically, 1/3 and 3/4, and then we would change the numerator here. 3 times 4 is 12, so we have to multiply the numerator by 4 also. And then 4 times 3 is 12, so 3 times 3 is 9. And once you get those to have common denominators, you just add the numerators, keep the denominator. So notice when we're multiplying, we're actually multiplying by 1, because 4 over 4 equals 1, 3 over 3 equals 1. That means we're not changing the value of the fraction, we're just changing it to have a different denominator. So let's look at a little more complicated example, 8y cubed and 10y squared. The LCD here is 40y to the third power or cubed. Because whenever we have a variable, we use the highest power that we see in any single expression. So that's why we have the 3 there. And then 8 and 10, well, the first number that they both go into is 40. So that's how we get the 40y cubed. So we're going to multiply each of those by 1 to build that up to have the common denominator. For this, we need to multiply by 5 over 5 because 8 times 5 would be 40, and we already had the y cubed. So we just get 40y cubed, and on the top we get 25. For the second one, we need to multiply 10 by 4 to get 40, but also we only had 2 y's here, so we need to multiply by y to get that to be y to the third power. 3 times 4y on the top is 12y. Now that they both have 40y cubed in the denominator, we can put those together and keep the denominator the same. I could write that as 25 plus 12y or 12y plus 25, and I typically write the variable term first because that's usually how we do it. We always want to check to see if we can simplify. Is there a common factor between 25, 40, and 12? And there is not one that goes into all three of those. In the next example, we just have two distinctly different denominators, x minus 3 and x plus 3, so the LCD would be the multiplication of those two. Notice we don't multiply those out because it's easier in the end to decide whether we can simplify or not if we've left our denominator in factored form. So the LCD then being these two binomials, the first one had the x minus 3 but did not have the x plus 3. So we're going to multiply by 1, which x plus 3 over x plus 3 equals 1. And that gives us our denominator. I don't FOIL that out. I'm going to leave that as two distinct parts. And then I have this, though, 5 times x is 5x, and 5 times 3 is 15. So I do multiply the numerator out. And then on this side, I was missing the x minus 3 in that second denominator. So multiplying by x minus 3 gives me the two binomials in the denominator, and then 2x minus 6 in the numerator. Now that I have those written with the same denominator, I can add those together. Here's the first term, and here's the second term. And I'm going to combine like terms. Excuse me, 5x and 2x is 7x, 15 minus 6 is 9, and that goes over the LCD. Frequently, people leave the LCD out and just write 7x plus 9, and that's a very different answer. So make sure to include your LCD, just like you would anytime you're working with fractions. In our fourth example, we have, again, whole numbers in the denominator, but we have binomials up top. But we can see that the LCD for 12 and 4 is 12. So that first term doesn't change. I'm not multiplying it by anything. The second one I have to multiply by 3. 4 times 3 is 12. And then if I distribute the 3 times b is 3b, and 3 times 2 is 6. And now I can combine those two because they have the same denominator. But remember, when you do that, you want to distribute that negative sign through there. So I have b, and then I have minus 3b, and then I have minus 4, but I also have minus 6. Remember, that negative sign goes all the way through. When I add those together, I get negative 2b and negative 10. Now that has a common factor of 2 in it. In a couple different ways to look at that, but the way I would want you to do it is to take out the common factor in the numerator. And so we can factor out that negative 2, and that would leave b plus 5 if you think about redistributing that negative 2b minus 10. And then we can cancel the 2 and the 12 and get 1 on the top and 6 on the bottom. But we don't need to show the 1 because it's not necessary. If we canceled that out, there's three different ways I think that you could show your answer. That is negative b plus 5 over 6. Or you could distribute that negative, negative b minus 5 over 6. Or you could leave the negative out front, not in the numerator, but out front of the entire fraction. And that's a little tricky because sometimes when you, if you go to use it somewhere else, you have to remember that it distributes. So I would suggest one of the first two, but this third one is a perfectly acceptable way to write that. And finally, example 5, we are subtracting, but we have two binomials here, but just one here. But if I look at the LCD for this, I definitely need an x minus 1, but I already have an x minus 1 here, so I'm going to just add the 2x plus 3. So the LCD is this term, and that means, again, I don't need to change this term. It already has the LCD. This one is missing the 2x plus 3, so if I multiply by 1, that's going to be 2x plus 3 over itself. And then that gives me the denominator that I want, not factored, but left in binomial form. And then here, 10x plus 15. Now, because they have the same denominator, I can combine those up. The 10x plus 15 minus the 9x plus 16 that I had to start with. Again, don't forget to distribute 10x minus 9x and 15 minus 16. And that's going to give me x, and then 15 minus 16 is minus 1. Because I have a common binomial on top and bottom, I can cancel those out. When I cancel a binomial, I leave a 1 behind, so that leaves me 1 over 2x plus 3. All right, have a fantastic day.